What up? It's your boy T-Bird and Reaction. Today's Music Monday. About to get into some saluting to some floppy discs with Gigi Ramirez. So what's up? So I told you before I'm skipping the episode because I already did it already. So episode 37 was the title song for this series. So what's up by Gangstar, where I think came out off the Moment of Truth or no. It was their full clip exclusive, I think. So anyway, either way, I think that was. So now we're down to, we have down 38. And after that, we only have two more left. And this is with Crumb Snatcher called Getting Closer to God. Now, it's probably one of the ones I probably heard about beat and sound, but never knew the name of it or name the artist. But not too familiar with this. So let's see how DJ Premier break this down. So without further ado, so what's up? Episode 38, Crumb Snatcher, Getting Closer to God. Let's sloop to floppy disk. Let's get it. Interesting cover right there. You know, you always have some dope album covers in the background. So let's get it.
I'm DJ Premier and I present to you, So What's Up.
Okay, computer, run it back.
So what's up? 1997. Mm-hmm. Good year for hip hop.
Yep, it was.
Just the whole 90s era.
Of course.
It's a good just era.
Nothing gets the current. Nothing gets 2000, the 2010s, and the current 2020s. I'm not going to, before anybody makes a mistake, you know I'm not the type that downplays the newer era. I like the newer era stuff, music as well, too. I mean, but 90s was the shit. Still is.
You know, they call it the golden era. We were part of the golden era. 80s is still my favorite time for me because what came before me is what inspired me to do music in the 90s, which is the era that we quote unquote ran. Production was up. Gangstar was doing very good.
Close one. We'll start freeze up. Here we go.
Peace to Guru, always.
Always.
Gangstar for life. Shout out to Big Shug, the other co-founder of Gangstar and the logo. Don't get it twisted. Now, the reason why I'm kind of just yipping and yapping all these different ways is because this leads to another part of the Massachusetts sound and style of artists that come from there, which are so many dope MCs are from Boston and Massachusetts in general. But we're going to a town called Lawrence, Massachusetts. They call it Law Town if you know what time it is in the street. Okay. All right? Shout to Terminology. Shout to Easy Money. Shout to DJ Deadeye.
Yep.
Shout to everybody that comes from Law Town. Even Static Selector temporarily lived in Law Town. And can't forget this guy. 1997, I was introduced through mutual friends to an artist named Crumb Snatcher. Mm-hmm. All right, shout to Low and Pace, those were his business partners. When they approached me about doing this record, they had a label called MIA, which stood for Mass in Action. They put me in contact with them and they said, this guy can really, really rhyme and he has a concept of a record that he says only you can do and he wants to explain it to you. That man came up with a record called Getting Closer to God. I know getting's not on there. As you see from the old writing, it probably just didn't fit when I wrote it on the disc. But
of course,
Closer to God.
Of course, man. Even half my songs I produce, beats I make, the whole song's not on what I saved it as or anything. Some of you have the original song, the original name I had it, or the name I just gave it, just like have something to save it as well, too. While the original, the official name or the working title is on the stuff I have on SoundCloud or the final save.
Just as close as Getting Closer to God. Plus you can check the label right there. This is the deal. Crumb Snatcher came to D&D Studios where I was working at the time. And he came in and said, look, I have a record that's totally a true story about my life. I just got through going through getting out of jail. I just got through getting out of the hospital from being shot 5 times. I have a story that I want to talk about that's regarding me living through this. So when he met me in person he laid out the scratch ideas, which were the lines, getting closer to God in a tight situation. Shout to Prodigy, rest in peace. Let me be your angel and I'll be your protection. Shout to the God, Rakim Allah. And shout to Snoop D-O-double-G from Murder Was the Case. I stopped breathing. Damn, I see demons. And those were the cuts. And I was like, oh man. So when he explained the rhyme to me and everything, I was like, well, let's hear it. He said, I already have it written out. And he said, now let's do the beat. Now the crazy thing was, when I made the beat, the beginning section that he's actually talking over in the intro was what he rapped over through the whole song. The change up on the hook happened to be the section that he's rhyming on the official record. It was flip-flopped. So when we played the record back, I was like, he did it to the intro part. And I was like, you know what? Why don't we let the hook part be the part that you do the verse over? You don't have to do anything. I'll just flip-flop it and re-dump it. Now, the reason why I say dump it is because, as you know, the sounds that are contained on what you hear when you hear the official record being played to you are all stored on this floppy disk. See how thin it is? Right, like I said, thin like a waffle. Thinner than a waffle. They're stored on this, and then they're put through a machine that we were using at the time called the Akai S950 sampler. Now, from here, we trigger these sounds with a drum machine that's called the Akai MPC 60. And when you MIDI them up, MIDI is the cords that you plug in from each machine to each other, and they're set up to be able to start and move exactly in sync when the reel to reel, that's what we were using, and that was all synced up through a process of a box called the Roland SBX80.
My fault.
When that's plugged into the tape machine, there's a language and signal that's sent to it called SMPTE. S-M-P-T-E. All right, it was a very common new way of what we call time code, and it was used for so many years during our career. And that's.
Hold on, so I'm gonna keep coughing your ear like that. My bad, I ain't gonna keep coughing your ear. My throat's got hello drive out of nowhere, but yeah.
That's how a lot of these hip-hop records were classically done. So with this, if you listen to the beginning, actually, let's play the instrumental of the beginning so you could just kind of hear what he originally was going to write, what he originally rapped over, and we ended up flip-flopping it and moving around. Here's the beginning part that he rapped on through the whole song. Now, here's a little piece of the instrumental that we used just for the hook, but we ended up flip-flopping it to make it for the verses, which was the best idea that we did. Here's the instrumental to the hook.
Ooh. That's way better, yeah.
Now, as you see, the emotion of the hook part totally sounds like what he spoke about. He'd been shot 5 times. He's in the hospital, handcuffed to a gurney because he was going through whatever he was going through. And obviously, when the police are involved and whatnot, and a shooting or someone's shot, if you're a suspect, they will handcuff you. Even if you've been shot, you could be dying. They're still going to handcuff you in the hospital until everything gets squared away.
Crazy.
During that time, as we started the process of finishing the record and getting it out there, next thing you know, the record was an instant hit. I mean, it immediately popped off. And we were so happy for him, because not only that, to be another Massachusetts artist that we didn't really know about at that time, because you have artists like RSO,
yep,
and LOG, and
oh, LOG like from Boston,
that really had Boston on lock with running the hip hop scene. Here comes Crumb Snatcher, you know what I'm saying? So, as I said before,
here we go.
Once the record was out, the next stage was a connection with Guru, because he loved the record so much that he was like, yo, man, fast forward to 1998. When we were working on our album, Moment of Truth, mm-hmm, he was like, we got to put Crumb Snatcher on the album. Nice. I'm like, I'm with it. We did a song called Make 'Em Pay. All right? It's on the B-side of our album. Once we did Make 'Em Pay, when Guru laid his verse, spit it real magnificently, and then Crumb Snatcher closed it out, there's a thing in the Source magazine, which at that time, the Source magazine was our Bible,
yep,
of hip-hop culture. Anything came out with hip-hop, you had your Word Ups, you had your Rap Pages, you had all these different magazines. But the Source at that time, this is before the digital Source, this is the magazine version. Mm-hmm. It was the end-all, be-all of wanting to be in that magazine just for clout and to know that you have hit a certain milestone in your career. So during that time, there was a section in the Source called Hip Hop Quotables. And every artist you could think of that really got rhymes would be in that Hip Hop Quotable. And if you were in it, that meant so much on every level of you being certified. How does an unknown like Crumb Snatcher, mm-hmm, get in the Hip Hop Quotable, because his verse was that crazy? Matter of fact, you gotta hear it. To get a Hip Hop Quotable as an unknown artist, very rare, but Crumb Snatcher got it. Check this out on our album, Moment of Truth, Make 'Em Pay. Listen.
I see myself as the black rap messiah, colossal, spreading my gospel through electrical wires. Spit five and speaks so I can reach each and every Tom, Dick, and Jerry, slipping like petroleum jelly. Too busy in the limelight, can't rhyme tight. I got divine right to bring dark to light. Something ain't right to be an MC. You got a thug, or the thug, you gotta be an MC. This shit is bug, show love with few. Deal with crew and crew only, and think universal like Sony. Phony pounds and fake hugs is usually avoided. Give a fuck like Pizza Hut, I gotta stay noided. Cause that same nigga you trust could be that same cat behind that gat that busts. Quiet ya with the silencer, keep it hush, ashes to dust, then dust to ashes. Nowadays is who pull out the fastest. Imagine this rap shit without this gas shit, or the phony cat in black talking about how much his max spit. But this year, Gangsta got changes being made. No action being played, or fake max getting paid, or Versace MCs with a mouth full of mo, sounding like a hoe, spitting that old fashioned show flow. I bombshell that pastel Chanel rap through a Maxwell. Ever since Young Crumb was taught to rap well, going deep, process of thought when my eyes closes, awaken with interpretive robe and sandals like Moses. Traveling high sands and eastern lands for the answers. Ignorance is spreading through the streets like it was cancer. Too many drinking, not thinking, we're behind that trigger. I 38 escalate the murder rate for us niggas. It's like microphone roulette, cause nowadays them seasons getting wet over someone else's fake gangsta rap.
You see? That right there got him hit by Quotable, and then from there, shout to Steve Stout, one of the first people to reach out, say he's interested in possibly doing a deal with Crumb Snatcher at Interscope. Shout to all the labels that were definitely, you know, doing bidding wars and whatnot. And it was a dope-ass time of the 90s for someone like Crumb Snatcher to be approached just for that one song and to have a tight single to give the next level of him, which at that time he was doing a project called Snatcher Season. So,
I heard that.
Not only that, 2001, the blockbuster hit movie Training Day put together an incredible soundtrack, predominantly hip-hop, and with raw artists, Gangstar appeared on it, and also Crumb Snatcher got to appear as one of the lead singles featuring M.O.P. called Wolves, a hardcore
record,
one of the greatest records ever to come out. And what a cast in that movie. Denzel Washington, Ethan Hawke, Eva Mendez, Snoop Dogg, Macy Gray, and so many others.
And Dr. Dre.
You can't forget also Dr. Yep. Dre. All right, it was a dope ass movie, one of the most memorable movies of just great films. And Crumb Snatcher has continued to put his music out and do his thing. But one thing you'll never forget is what this has done.
And you know how we do.
Here we go.
Now let's let you hear a little bit of the way it was flip-flopped, because we're about to load this up into the S950 sampler, connected to the MPC 60 or MPC 62. Had them both. Press that button on the play start, and this is what you get.
Primo, D-A-D-R. That's right. I want to speak a little truth about what guns is really about. Cause me being victim of guns, it was an experience of getting closer to God.
Come on.
Since the day I was young, I had premonitions of an ending to come behind the brow of the next man's gun. It used to be fun when I'm the one doing the clapping. Now I'm facing my death, doing fast breath, no laughing. How can this happen? Holding my chest on the floor, laid up or sprayed up, dreaming to even the score. Bright lights all I saw, my life flashed before me. From a distance I heard a faint voice steady call me. I guess my time is here, suppress my fear, I'm ready. Trying to breathe steady, feeling my legs getting heavy. Lord, don't let me die this young without leaving the sun. The carry tradition, listen, my life has just become a nightmare flick, visions are swinging the pool stick, depicted by near death. I turn left and pull quick, lost control of my mind, flip the safety off the nine and squeeze, chase them down, discharging rounds that fell on my knees.
There it is. Salute to Lawrence. Ooh. Mass, as they call it, Lawtown. Alright, and as I said before, man, one of the best parts of history is done right here with this guy, Crumb Snatcher. Salute to him. And he also went on the Gangstar tour with us when we were touring with Common on the Electric Circus tour. And that tour actually was us, a brand new group called Flowetry. Shout out to Marsha Ambrosius. Also, Talib Kweli was on the tour, and Talib Kweli brought Kanye West to maybe like after the fifth show to go on with the tour with us. And I said, why you got Kanye on the tour? He said, because he gave me a hit record called Get By, didn't charge me a dime, and it's my first big radio hit. And I was like, that's dope. And that's when Kanye told me he was gonna start rapping and become a rap artist. And he did. And he said he was going to go platinum first go around. And he did.
Yep.
Shout out to Ye. Shout out to everybody that was involved on that tour. And again, shout out to Common. Shout out to Erykah Badu, who was on the tour during that time with us on certain dates. And it was a fun run. And Crumb Snatcher was part of it. And Crumb Snatcher also appeared on our album, The Owners, on the intro song, Put Up or Shut Up. So we have continued to always connect here and there. And again, salute to his career. And salute to the floppy disk. That's what's up.
Raymond, damn, damn. Nice. Good episode right there, definitely. Had to throw that joint on my B-side. I'm planning on blasting doing a recording mix, whether it's put on MixCloud and or do a live video mix or anything too. But other than that, this was a good episode of So What's Up. We're down to two left now. So if you like my reaction, like, share, subscribe my YouTube channel. It's your boy T-Bird signing off. One love.